Hey everybody, BlendMaster here with another tutorial, and today I'm going to be showing you guys how to create this cool morph effect inside of Blender. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to take two images and put them inside of Blender. And we're going to be using shape keys so that we can adjust each image to look more like the other image, and that'll help us so that when we fade in from one image to the other, it'll look more like a morph instead of just a transition from one image to the next. So let's jump into Blender and get started. First thing we want to do is delete the cube and the lamp, and then we're going to press Shift A and add an image as plane. We're going to select our first picture. Then I'm going to press 7 and 5 on the numpad, and press S to scale up our image, and I'll type in 5. And I'm also going to switch over to material view, and under the material settings here, we're going to check shadeless, so that it doesn't matter if there's no light or not, we'll still be able to see our picture clearly. Now I'm just going to move this up slightly by pressing G, Z, and typing in 0.1. And I'm going to add in our second image by pressing Shift A and going to Image as Planes and selecting it. And I'm going to do the same thing here, select Shadeless, and then just scale it up to about there. And we're going to check Transparency and set it to Z Transparency. Now let's select the picture of the rock again, make sure Transparency is checked, as well as switch to Z Transparency. We're going to set this alpha to about 0.5 just so that it's a little bit transparent and we can sort of match this over the top of our second picture like this. And this part doesn't have to be perfect because you're going to fix this when we're actually morphing our two pictures together. So I think that looks about good, so let's set that back to 1 and let's tab into edit mode. Press W to subdivide, let's set the subdivisions to 10, and let's subdivide it again and set it to 5. Okay, that's looking good. Now let's come over here to these settings and add a new shape key, so tab out of edit mode. Press this plus button here, and this will add the basis for our shape key. So this is the base shape of our object. And now if we add a key, if we were to change this object somehow by just stretching it around like this, if you look at this key now, when we animate this value, it'll change from our first shape to our second shape. So let's just delete that key and create a new one. And let's go into edit mode now. And I'm going to set the alpha to 0.5. And with proportional editing enabled, all you want to do is select some points around the face and with your middle mouse button scroll in to adjust the sphere of influence. And you just want to match these points along the head so that it looks right. You want to do that with every major body part, like the ears over here, as well as the eyes and nose and mouth. So I'm going to speed up the video right here, and I'll come back when I'm done. Alright, so it looks like I'm done matching up our first face with our second one, so we can tab out of edit mode and then change the shape key value to 1 just to see how it looks. And if we change this alpha to 0, it should look like it overlays perfectly. And I think that's pretty good. So now what we want to do is change this back to 0. And let's select our second image here. And let's just move it slightly above our first image. And let's go back to material settings again. Let's add a shape key for this picture. And we're going to do the same thing over again, because we want this face to transition with our other face as well. Otherwise, it'll look like the first image is just fading into the second image. So let's tab into edit mode, press W to subdivide, set the cuts to 10, and subdivide it again and set it to 5. Let's make sure we have our shape key added. And now we can adjust this alpha again to about 0.5. And just start editing around until the faces match. Now, I recommend starting with the general outline of the head and then going to the nose, since it's directly in the center and it'll affect the most places. And then you can start with the ears, the mouth, the eyes, and then the eyebrows. So I'm gonna pause it now and speed up, and I'll come back when I'm done. So I think that's pretty much it for editing our second picture. Let's just change this value to 1, and let's take a look at it. And if we switch it, it looks like it matches on pretty well. So let's press Alt-G to move it back to the center where we had it originally. Let's go to top view, orthographic view. Press Ctrl-Alt-0 on the numpad to snap our camera to our view. And let's change it to orthographic. And just zoom in slightly like that with the orthographic scale. I'm also going to change the resolution to 1080 by 1920. And I'm going to move this around so it's positioned a bit better and play around with the scale. I think that looks pretty good already. Maybe zoom in a little bit. And I think that looks pretty good. So now the easy part, all we have to do is animate it. So for our first frame, we want everyone to look normal. So let's keep Dwayne Johnson as 0 for his first shape key, and then keep his alpha at 1. And for our second picture, we want to keep his alpha at 1 as well, but we want his face to match Dwayne Johnson's, so set that to 0. And let's go to frame 24 so that 1 second later everything will still be the same. So let's just add a keyframe everywhere that we already added one. and we want our morphing transition to last about 2 seconds. So at frame 72, it should be done. So at this frame, we want Dwayne Johnson to have completely transformed. So set the shape key to 1 and press I to insert the keyframe. And we want him to have completely faded out. So change the alpha to 0 and insert a keyframe. And then let's select our second image here. We want him to still be visible, so keep the alpha at 1. And go to his shape key, and you want to make sure it's set at 0. And I think we forgot to set his shape key to 1 at first. So let's just quickly do that. Because in the beginning we want him to look like Dwayne Johnson, so let's hide him right now. And you can see, yeah, he looks like Dwayne Johnson for the first second, and then he starts to transform. So let's unhide our first image by pressing Alt-H. And let's go to our first frame and just scrub along the timeline to see how it looks. And I think that looks pretty good. We want our final image to last about another second. So let's make the end frame frame number 96. Let's go to our render settings now, change this from PNG to that, and let's name it Morph Result. And I'm going to render this out and come back when it's done. Alright, it's done rendering, so let's take a quick look at it. Let me just open it here. And that looks pretty good. So that's pretty much it for this tutorial, guys. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned something new. And obviously, the longer you take on the transition part of this, where you're trying to match the two faces together, the better the outcome of the morph will look. So thanks again for watching. If you have any suggestions for future tutorials, feel free to leave them in the comments below. And also, if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments. I'll try to get back as soon as possible. And don't forget to like and subscribe. Bye!